Hey everyone, ArdrethShadow here, and welcome back to Hush Hush. Well, the demo of it, anyway. So previously, I started the demo, and we were sent out on a quest by two very voluptuous goddesses to save these five lovely ladies in front of us. Well, we don't know it yet, because I haven't gone through the whole story, but... anyway... speaking of the whole story, there's still quite a bit to go through, and there's still a lot of content to technically unlock. So, so I'm not sure how many videos I'm going to be able to dedicate to it, but for starters, I'm just going to go through the demo very casually, and then I'll go back and start doing whatever else to unlock whatever secrets that I can. Anyway, today felt like 2 days. You're asleep as soon as your head hits the pillow. You had a strange dream last night. There were cats and rats and elephants. Hopefully none of it was symbolic. If it was, I don't know what any of that would mean. Oh my god, it's little Quill. And is that Quill's bell right there? What are you doing with pictures of Quill in your house? Man. Let's see here. Well, I like the ambience here. Well, okay, I'm gonna have to see if I can see. Required level, mirror level. Okay, I'm not high enough yet. Okay, well, I guess let's see what I can do with the work here. Okay, so that didn't take up a whole lot of time, thankfully. Oh, what do we have here? Greetings, Mystic here, your friendly neighborhood psychic. If you're wondering how I got your number, well, please see previous message. Now that you and I are acquainted, I actually have a small offer to make. As you know, the services I offer come with a bit of a price tag. Looking into the future is thirsty work. And a psychic's gotta eat. Drink. And the drink is coffee. In any case, these costly predictions are just for the juicy stuff. The stuff you need to know to make all your hopes and dreams come true. I do, however, offer a free service. Daily reading. A daily reading that should prove pretty useful. Sort of a hint horoscope. A hintoscope. Ooh, I like that. I wonder if I can trademark that. Anyway, if you're already, let's say familiar with how things work around here, these messages might feel a bit unnecessary. But if perhaps you're in the market for a hint or two, I would be pleased to send you a freebie every day. What do you say? Let's see, yes, please sign me up for the daily hint. Or no thanks, I got this. You know what, let's just go with it. You got it. Okay, this isn't like the crush phone fling thing. And if you wish to unsubscribe at any time, just text me your credit card number for verification. Sorry, that's a joke. I'm not great at texting. Cheers. I look forward to... well, that's a thing, isn't it? I look forward. Best of luck out there. Alright. So we can either go to the bakery, the cafe... the hint again. Although... gosh, do I have to actually go see him for this? Let's see. So you peek down the alley to see if Mystic's tent is there. Well, it's still there. Sure enough it is. Mystic is already sitting at his crystal ball, in his wizard robe, reading his cell phone. You walk up quietly, and he reaches for a cup of coffee.
Hey, welcome back.
Alright. Your first fortune is going to cost $1.
What happened to the freebie?
Don't get too excited. Like I mentioned, each time you use my service, the price goes up.
Okay, well, so far it hasn't gone up like a whole lot, it's just $1.
Shall we get started?
Actually, no, I changed my mind.
There is no greater act of mental fortitude than the power to change one's mind. It's commendable, so I commend it. Cheers.
Okay, that's that. Let's see what's going on at the bakery.
Hey, sugar. Welcome back. As you can see, we've got no shortage of shortbread or lack of lax bread.
Huh?
So let me know if anything catches your attention.
What the... I didn't even get a chance to buy anything. Okay. Well, that was pretty weird. Alright, and as you can see, the mall is not open. Well, right now. It was for the previous time, but... Like I said, once I'm done, I'm gonna go back and see. There is a channel out there that I've been kind of keeping tabs on. Another person who's played through a lot of the Sad Panda games. I cannot pronounce their channel name for the life of me, so I might just put like an annotation somewhere. But I guess first I'll just say I'd like to thank them for kind of sort of hinting me that there is a lot more to the demo than I initially thought there was. And I'm going to kind of sort of dissect their videos a bit to see what I can do with mine. Okay, I'm going to ignore the cafe for now, and we're going to go to the beach event. As you're making my... damn it! I was going to say making my way downtown, and... no.
Making my way downtown, walking fast, faces pass, and I'm homebound.
As you're making your way along the beach boardwalk, you spot a pretty girl in a bikini, handing out coffee. Which girl would this be? Oh, okay. Well, I don't know if it's Iroh or somebody else. As you get closer, you can see that she's actually packing up her things.
Oh, hello again. It's me, Lotus, from the Queen Bean.
Oh my god, Lotus. Oi, oi, oi. I was not expecting to see you in... well...
As you can see, I'm not in my usual uniform, in case you didn't recognize me.
Oh yeah, you're definitely not in your usual uniform, that's for sure. Yep, you're definitely not in your usual uniform.
I hope you didn't have your hopes set on one of our delicious and invigorating cups of coffee, did you?
So I'm wondering if you could possibly pick up Lotus? I mean, the Lemus did say you could pick up lovers on the side. I'm just here like, huh, now you have me curious. Are we gonna end up with some kind of crazy harem ending? No worries, I'll drop by the cafe later for a less than free sample. Well, I didn't. But now, I mean, you made it sound pretty great. Wow, excuse me, did you say bikini? Free samples of bikini? What the f- Orale. I don't know. So what are you gonna do?
Oh, I know. You can have a sample of my coffee. It's right here in this thermos.
Okay.
This is actually a really special coffee. It's called my Super Brew Supreme. And I don't actually make it for customers, because the beans were a gift from my uncle in Kona. So it's your lucky day. Try it. I help, it energizes and refreshes you.
You try the coffee. It is insanely good, and it does indeed energize and refresh you.
Hope to see you at the Queen Bean soon. Have a great day!
Well, I'm already having a great day if I get to see you here. Lotus loads all of her coffee stuff into her car and drives away. You lick the cup clean and consider eating it. The coffee is that good. Man, if it makes you consider eating a cup, then yeah, it must be pretty good. What the? Oh wow, look at all that. You sadly throw it away and continue on with your day. Oh my. Okay, so that was that. Oh, hello.
Hello. This is Lotus from the Queen Bean Coffee House. Hola, aloha, and hello. Just a friendly announcement to perk your interest. Queen Bee Coffee House is now offering our legendary summer specialty, eggplant spiced lattes. We hope to see you soon. Aloha.
Never spam this number again! Okay, I'm not gonna be mean to her. I mean, she's so nice, so...
You're welcome!
Like, why would you do that to her? Oh, what the... let me see here. Greetings, Mystic here, with your daily dose of Hintoscope. You see those fancy skills you can upgrade? Well, here's a tip. You don't need to keep them equal. In fact, some of them will prove more useful than others. Each trait has a 100% chance of being someone's favorite. But some of the skills are popular with nearly everyone. Keep in mind, though, that you will need to keep all your skills humming if you're aiming for a happy ending. And yes, that was a tip and an innuendo. Sorry, again. Not so great at texting. That's all for today. Cheers. And Mio.
Hey, stranger. Remember me?
No. I mean, yes. How could I forget you?
I'm the weird chick that works at the arcade who was awkwardly flirting with you.
You awkwardly flirting with me? I was the one awkwardly flirting with you. I think you have things a little backwards.
Speaking of awkwardly flirting, I was kind of hoping to do a little more than that. But, like, not on company time. I'm not even sure if you're interested or available, but I thought I'd take a shot in the dark. Wanna go do something tonight? Or wanna go out tonight?
Or stop.
Wanna go out sometime tonight? I promise I can talk a lot less about video games. Or a lot more. I'm versatile, so...
Let's see here. I can't do tonight. I've already got plans. Okay, so I guess if I had gone to the mall, maybe I would have met Cassie. And, well, this is me assuming that Cassie would have been there. Although, like I said, I did peek into that person's videos a little bit, and I did see some bits of, or, well, God no. I did see some footage of Cassie here and there, and it looked like a mall. But anyway, let's see. Well, you know I can't say no to Mio. I'd love to go out sometime. When? Where? How? Why? Let's see. Alright, let's see what she says.
Fantastic! After I'm off work is usually the best time. Why don't you drop by tonight? I can head somewhere else, or I can lock down the arcade and we can have free time, or free rent of the place.
Oh, hello. Okay, well, I did actually spoil this for myself a bit, so I have an idea of what we might be in for.
I'm sure we'll find something fun to do. See you tonight.
Alright. Catch you on the flip side. Let's see.
Hey, sugar. I'm glad you're here. I need your opinion on something.
Okay, you're not just gonna tell me, oh, we have all this stuff, and then shoo me out, are you?
There's this baking competition coming up back home in Georgia, and I'm mulling over whether I should go.
Okay, confirmed. Bonnabelle comes from Georgia.
Normally I wouldn't bother, but one of my rivals from high school has been calling me out on social media. Bless her heart.
Oh, hello.
I would take immense satisfaction from teaching her some manners. What do you think?
Let's see here. Nah, don't let haters take up shop in your head. I would go, glory is all. Sheesh. And well, come to think of it, last episode I was talking about how I had a notebook or whatever. So let me just... So in this case, I think I'm just going to tell her to go. Just because... Obviously, I'm going to have to come back to this later, so...
Well, someone certainly has a flair for the dramatic. I think you're right, though, Sugar. It sounds like fun, at least, and it'll be a good chance to visit my sisters.
Yeah, Baby Belle and Mary Belle. Who I really do hope make it into Crush Crush somehow, someday.
The competition is in a few months, so don't you worry your pretty little head. I'm not up and disappearing soon.
Okay, that's good. I was almost about to... I kind of thought that that would have been like a bad option. But okay. We still have time.
Thanks for the advice. I appreciate it, Sugar.
Okay, so it looks like we do have, like, these little events here. You know, let's just go to the cafe. I'm not gonna buy anything, though.
So, I gave him $400, and he said he'd get it back to me by next week.
There's Dimitri.
Dimitri, that was very foolish. But save your story. We have a customer. Hola, aloha, and hello. Welcome to the Queen Bean Coffee House. What can I get for you today?
Okay, large coffee please, or nothing right now, thanks.
No problem. Let us know if you change your mind.
And then I get kicked out. You know, that's good. Well, technically, no, it's not really bad business. I suppose they follow the mantra of buy or get lost. Okay, well, let's see what we have going on here. Oh my, it's Alpha. Yeah, Alpha Prelude. Well, she is in the game, although actually, what am I saying? I don't know if she is, like, one of the bonus girls you can go after. Anyway, arriving at the mall, you're somewhat taken aback by the sheer size of it. More than 300 stores on 3 floors. It makes the Times Square Mall look kind of... not the Times Square Mall, but... Like, it makes the Times Square look tiny! Alright, no. Finding a parking spot alone takes more than 20 minutes. And by the time you reach the front entrance, you're already noticeably hot and somewhat winded. I need oxygen! Luckily, the distinct chill of a powerful air conditioner greets you as you enter, and the smell of popcorn and fancy chocolates promises you things are better in here. You explore a bunch of the shops as you slowly make your way, peeking into more than a dozen shops, offering hats called caps, cabs, and passing by a suspicious number of cinnamon bun shops. Finally, as you're passing a store called the Chic Boutique, you hear a familiar voice, Yoo-hoo, come from the back of the store.
Yoo-hoo! Why, look who it is! My cute little beach bum buddy!
Okay. Kind of fancy running into you here, Eli. I was almost expecting to run into you at the beach.
I'm so glad you're here. I didn't get the chance to give you my and Eero's num-nums while we were frolicking on the sands. Hand me your phone. I shall correct this grievous oversight immediately.
Much obliged to you, my good fellow sir.
There. Done. Now you can send Eero all the cute kitty memes your heart desires and fill my inbox with all the dirty little texts your mind can conjure.
Oh, hello.
Just be super careful not to mix those two up. Can you imagine? Sending me kitty memes! I'm practically squeeing my face off just thinking!
Does that mean we could kill Eli by sending kitty memes? Oh, jeez. Well, we don't want to murder Eli.
Now, other than another fantastically fateful meeting with yours truly, what brings you to the mall? Did you run out of gum while you were out kicking ass? Do you just like the smell of air conditioning and chubby tourists?
It's time to chew bubblegum and kick some ass, and I'm all out of gum. Hail to the king, baby. Let's see, two words, food court. Mixing and matching foods from across the fast food rainbow. The guilty pleasure of kings. Just looking around. Look at what I'm wearing. Obviously, I'm here for help. My wardrobe is in desperate need of a purgency. So how should I do this? Okay, let's see. What happens if... I have a feeling that if we go with this, Eli would have a field day with us here.
Yes! At long last, destiny has called my name, and I shall answer. For what you need, you have come to the right place. You have come to Eli.
Eli, do you own this store, or are you just a regular customer here?
All right, enough small talk. Let's get down to business. As you can see, you are standing in Cheek Boutique, where all your dreams come true. It also happens to be my throne of power.
Okay. Although I still don't know if it's your store or not.
Here at Cheek Boutique, fashion is our passion ration. And I would love, love, love to make you my lovely little Autobot and help transform you.
Oh my god! Eli, do you know who you're talking to? Oh my god. Oh my god. My interests are very unconventional. Show me. And then I just show you my Transformers collection.
You're the light, you're the night, you're the color of my blood. You're the cure, you're the pain, you're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it could mean so much, so much.
Damn, well, okay, so I guess this is his store, and apparently he knows about Transformers, like, well, I don't know. Are you a casual fan or a hardcore fan? Because... no.
I'm going to hand you clothes, you're going to take them to the dressing room, and you're going to put them on and start whispering tearful thank yous to your Eli.
Alrighty then. Okay, let's see what he gets for us then.
Okay, chop chop chop! Fortune favors the bold, and judging by what you were wearing when you came in here, you're most definitely the bold type.
Well, considering I can't see what I'm wearing, I'm just gonna take your word for it.
Oh, and don't look at the price tags. Those are merely suggestions, like pants and speed limits.
Okay, then. Living life on the dangerous side, are we?
Here you go, here you go, here you go! All right, you're set. See you shortly!
Alright, here we go. You walk over to the fancy change room with easily $2,000 worth of designer clothes, including at least one pair of assless chaps. Oh god. Man. A lot of my high school friends and I used to joke about, like, assless chaps, and it seems like, well, the assless chaps have come back to haunt me in some form. What can I get for $15? God, this is gonna hurt, isn't it? Well, if it does, I saved. For a moment, you feel utterly lost, as there are no signs directing where exactly to go or wait. You awkwardly try to see if anyone is already in the room, but it's too difficult to tell. Just as you decide to turn back and summon Eli for help, your foot catches the corner of a short bench, causing you to toss your armload of clothes and topple into the changing room. Uh-oh, someone in there. Okay! Well, hello, Grumpy. finally meet at last, Cassie. It has been too long. Revealing a beautiful girl changing her clothes. Time feels like it slows down. So Waldo! As the two of you stare at one another in surprise. Just like an anime of some sort. Every detail seems important. The sharp gold of her hair, the tiny ears on her hat, the soft white frills on her underwear. The moment feels impossibly intimate. The softness of her breast, the firmness of her butt, her quiet expression of surprise. Then, you see a fire ignite in her eyes. Where's the fire? It's right in your ass, sugar.
What the hell, you perv? You're dead meat.
There, now I can die happily. A well-aimed high heel shoe clobbers you, and you drop to the floor stunned. You see a blush of blonde hair and soft breasts dash past you before everything goes black. You awake some time later to a concerned Eli.
Oh, wowzers, that's quite the bump on the old noggin. She got you good.
You know what, let's just go with this.
And my, isn't that just a fun sentence to be able to say? Now you've got an interesting story to tell.
Yeah, that's why I chose it. It is kind of a... It's an embarrassing sentence to say, but it's also kind of fun, too.
Lucky you! You have just had the pleasure of meeting one of Sub-Rosa's more colorful residents. Her name is Cassie, and she is a firecracker thrown into a burning microwave.
Well, that sounds fun. I wish I could have met her sooner, though. I don't know. I really don't know. Could I have met her on day one, or... Yeah, like I said, there's still a lot that I have to uncover here.
She comes in here all the time, tries on all the clothes, usually stuffs the odd thing into her bag, but... Oh dear lord, did you see her nails? That girl is a wizard with the filing board!
Let's see. Wait, did you say she shoplifts? She sounds like a handful.
Hee-hee! Of course! I mean, they say not to dip into the crazy pool. But it's right there! And there's a diving board, and the board's breasts are magnificent!
Well, I'll take a chance with a bit of crazy.
I mean, I would call the police or confront her or something for the shoplifting, but in all honesty, I'm super lazy, and everything she takes looks so good on her.
Okay, well, that's your call. But seriously, what am I gonna do, then? I can't pay for $2,000 worth of clothes! I mean, even if I had kept my $10, I still wouldn't be able to afford it.
Would you like her number? I've got it here. I snooped through her phone once when she was trying on some lace panties.
Oh, hello.
Beep, boop, beep. There you go. Just a word of the wise. Don't coddle that one. She's got daddy issues written all over her.
I see. Well, that's good to know.
Oh, and don't forget about Eero. I forgot I was trying to hook you up with her. Eero is so sweet and a tiger in bed, I imagine.
Oh, man. So she bangs like a tiger. Does Eero bang like a machine? Okay, no.
Whoops, look at the time. I need to take my 2-hour lunch. Thanks for dropping in again. See you soon. Bye!
I guess I don't have to worry about buying anything after all. Okay. So we're gonna go with Mio this time around. Oh, wait. Mystic. Greetings, Mystic here. Greetings, Mystic here with another Hindoscope. I know, I said I only send one per day, but I've got a great tip you should know about, so you're getting a bonus Hindoscope today. You might be wondering what you need cash for. I mean, besides the obvious allure of making it rain. Throw some glitter, make it rain. Cash isn't as important as it may seem, but there are a few ways it's helpful. And a couple of ways it's critical. First up, you need cash to buy coffee every day. I'm not joking.
At night or at dawn, consider sacrificing a skill point to work a job to get coffee money. If you get enough for two coffees, that's two stat points. Get in the habit, literally. Okay, so maybe I could have saved up. As for the big stuff, there are a few points where having a bunch of cash will be super useful, either to impress someone or get yourself out of a jam. Like, I think if we want to get with Cassie, if I know her well enough from Crush Crush, we've got to have money. Because that's kind of the girl she is. I'll give you a few more tips for those soon, but for now, here's a spoiler. One of your dates this week takes place at the mall. You'll need $160 during that date. Trust me, get the money. It'll save you from an awkward sitch. That's all for today. Cheers. And I almost have a feeling that that might be with Cassie, but I could be wrong. Okay. We're not gonna go there. Let's go to the mall real fast. We're gonna go back after we just left. Eli is sleeping. He seems to be a little hungover, judging from his appearance. Maybe you should let him sleep this one off. Then what was the point of doing that? Let's see. Well, Cassie is grumpy, so that's no surprise there. You stumbled into her life by stumbling into her change room. She seems assertive and a bit of a troublemaker, but open to your apology and flirting. Alright then. Euro. Okay, there is no stats here. Let's see, Bonnabelle. Okay. Yeah, so right now, I'm pretty much gunning for Mio. Well, let's face it, we all know that I want a gun for Mio here, but it seems like I'm already on her good side. So I definitely don't want to mess that up. Nope. Oh, dang it. This is what I want. Quick! There's a bunch of aliens taking over the mall! And they're demanding to speak to the most attractive Earthling! But I don't want to do it. They'll have to settle for number two. Which is you. Get over here right away! No, I'm not making this up because I'm bored. I need help. Please? Well, I went over there and you were sleeping, so... Sucks to be you. So, you're the peep and tom that tried to get a load of goods. I know it was you. My friend Eli tattled on you, and now you're in big trouble for messing with me. If I ever catch you in the street, I'm putting my boot where the sun don't shine. You understand me? Whoa, 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 this is just a misunderstanding. I'm blocking this number, don't bother message. God damn it. Okay, so you can intentionally do that, but I'm not going to. Plus, it's Cassie. You all also know that I love Cassie. Oh? And what exactly did I misunderstand exactly? Oops. Well, the part where you broke into the changing room? Or the part where you were oogling my delicates? It's not like that. I wanted to ask you out. I slipped, I promise. Oh my... Okay, gosh, I don't even know what would be the best one here. This isn't like the phone flings, where I guess everything goes to the same route. I mean, obviously you can choose to block Cassie's number, which I don't want to do. Girl, it was an accident, and I'd crawl on hot glass to get you to kick me in the junk. You are fine. Okay, let me see. Before I mess anything up, I'm gonna just do this again. Let's see, what if I... Oh gosh, the way I'm... Now I'm thinking about it, like... Ugh, I don't know. I feel like if you try to do the nice guy sort of thing, she's probably not gonna go for that. But then... Well, Cassie isn't so much of a mega bitch like Audrey is in Honey Pop.
And basically, if you want to deal with a mega bitch like Audrey, the only way is to be a total douchebag to her. But I'm just here like... So which one do I go with, the nice guy or the douchebag route? Well, let's see what being a douchebag does. I don't think it's going to be anything good, but we'll see.
Are you kidding me? You're flirting with me? While I'm laying this teardown on you? You got some guts, I'll give you that. I'm going to go cool down. Next time I text you, I'll decide whether I let you make up for this mess. Ciao for now.
Alright. Now, let's see if I try to be the nice guy here. Does Cassie like a nice guy? Okay, it looks like it almost doesn't make a difference here. Yeah, it doesn't make a difference. Okay, well, that's good to know. Alright, let's go to our arcade date with Mio. Anyway, what's this? Uh-oh. Is this basically like my way of telling if I'm screwing up or not? Or if I'm doing good? Well, I guess we're gonna find out. I'm probably gonna end up save scumming as much as I did in the last video. As you walk up to the arcade, the same sight smells, sounds and smell from earlier begin to creep into the consciousness. Somehow, even from outside, it has a foreboding musk. However, Mio quickly unlocks the door and lets you in. She gives you a quick wave and an awkward side hug, and then flourishes her hand toward the bar.
Welcome back to Rainy Day Arcade, the most romantic hotspot in town.
Is it now?
Tonight on the menu, we've got cheap beer, infinity quarters for the arcade, and the most brutal miniature golf course this side of the Lazy Link. I will be your date tonight. Please feel free to make inappropriate comments. But make no mistake, in this arcade, I am a goddess. You're going down.
Okay, I can already see we needed suave for something. So, yeah, I can't quite do that. I only have one, so... Oof, okay. Did you say cheap beer and infinity quarters? So I've died and gone to heaven. This is gonna make things awkward for my atheism. Let's see. Threatening me that I'll be the one going down tonight is a critical error. Do what you will. I've already won. Okay, well, I can't do that. You know, I knew there was something about this place that screamed romantic date. Probably that arcade over there that they're called Romantic Date!
Yeah, you got it. One does not simply walk in for rated A. Not without being attacked by sirens, flashing lights, and screaming children.
So pretty much the same way one does not simply waltz in to see the Earth King?
To make inappropriate... right? What's a heathen to do these days? What with all these heavenly bodies and whatnot?
You mean like the heavenly body I'm staring at right now? If you're gonna make it easy for me to do something like that, I'm gonna take my chance. And okay, so we do have like a little love meter going on here. Well, I guess thank goodness for save scumming, right?
Few good ideas of how we can kill some time in here, so it's worth the existential crisis. So, what brings you to Sombrosa anyway? Was it our expensive-ass craft beer industry, or the unusually high number of topless co-eds on our beaches?
What'd you say? Okay, well... I got that one right. Yeah, because, I mean, there's only one other option. We know that's not the right one. Let's see, I was aiming for a tourist trap to fall into for a month. Sun, surf, game, flirt. The topless co-eds did factor into my decision, but I also heard the arcade was staffed with hotties, so... Looked like a tool... No, Mio, I'm not going to call you a tool again. Well, you called me a tool before, so... Looked like a cool town to visit. I could tell it was cool by the way it was. Okay, I think this one's probably like the weak answer. Let's see.
Womp womp. I guess I can't fault you for the cheesy punchline when I give you a setup like that.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing. Well, obviously this isn't real life, otherwise you wouldn't be able to do this. No, don't save. Okay, so it's the other answer.
What brings you to Subrosa anyway? Was it our I hear ya. I tell you, if I could haul one of these arcades down to the beach so I could play in a bikini, wow.
Well,
that would be incredibly nerdy of me to admit, so I'm going to just alt F4 and abandon the thread. In any case, I've requested bikinis as an official uniform option here at Rated A, so maybe someday my dreams will come true.
Well then. I'm sure no one would complain about that. At least I wouldn't think so.
Well, I broke the ice. I suppose it's your turn to conduct the interrogation. What's on your mind?
Well, let's see. Tell me about yourself. You probably like stuff, hey? So let me guess, you're a gamer girl with a heart of gold on the search for the missing diamonds? Where's that damn fourth Chaos Emerald? Let's play a game. In three words, define yourself. God, I don't know. Well, like I said, I'm safe scumming this, so...
Yeah, I love stuff. I have a place full of stuff, and I'm always doing stuff, too.
Okay, well, at least that one worked. Finally, I didn't strike out with her.
Which conversation path will you take next, I wonder?
Oh boy. Let's see here. Oh man. Yeah, this one I can never answer just because my favorite game fluctuates pretty much depending on how I'm feeling. Let's see, let's play a game in three words, define yourself. Let's see.
Oh, yawn! You sound like a BuzzFeed article. Here are the top 10 reasons people use words. You'll never believe number 5.
Okay, so pretty much like WatchMojo. Alright, so... We don't want to try to sound like a WatchMojo list, so... Let's see. And... Well,
you tell me which kidney you like best, and I'll get back to you.
Okay. Alright, so it was the last one. Possibly.
Which conversation path will you take next, I wonder? That's awesome. Yes, you're exactly right, and I would have found them too if it weren't for those meddling kids. You look like you've got something to say, or an itch in a place you can't scratch. Either way, do it.
Do it. Make a sacrifice. Well, okay, we don't want to do this again. That actually took away from our affection. Well, I'm going to call it the affection meter because I don't know what else to call it. God, I don't know.
Got something to say. Or an itch in a place you can... Well... Alright, enough talk. It's my turn to choose. Now we get to the heart of the date. A little game I like to call Get Smashed Bros.
That's very nearly copyright infringement. You wouldn't download a car... You wouldn't download a car, would you? Yeah, I feel like she would probably hate that answer. Is this a scene that's going to get our dialogue censored in Australia? Let's talk more drink! Let's see... Okay, no, let's try this one.
This is definitely one of those adult situations the ESRB warned you about.
Okay, I thought so. Well, I mean, I thought so, but then I also thought so that that would be the better answer. Because, yeah, where it sounds like, oh, you're copyright infringing, you wouldn't do that, would you? It's like, yeah, that's also like a total buzzkill sort of thing. And oh my god, well, I see Crush and Pet-Pet, Monk-Monk. Yeah, this is totally Crush-Crush, but... you know, it looks like someone's taking somebody out on... well, that stroll there. Okay, well...
the rules are simple. We play Road Combat 2 Mondo. Every time you lose a stock, you take a shot. Lose a bout, and you lose some clothes. Sound good?
Let's see, I set my controls to inverted. I play 98 style. So like Star Fox 64? Let's see, wait, getting drunk and naked is the punishment? I love this game already! And you're totally comfortable with the fact that I'm about to get you drunk and naked? Okay, well... do we want to sound like don't get too cocky Star Fox, or pretty much be like... let's see.
You better hit that Ambien, cause you're already dreaming. We play Road Combat 2 Mondo. Oh man, are you in for a world of hurt?
Well, unfortunately, it seems like no matter what I do, it's gonna be... you know, since I can't get the suave, so I'm probably gonna need to come back and rework a few things here.
I'm gonna start things fair and not use my main, seeing as you're fighting out of your weight class.
Oh. Are you challenging me?
Alright, tequila is ready. The stage is selected. You better grip stick, because here I come!
Oh my... okay, we can't do hacking either way. Oh my god. Give it your all, surely you can beat an alt. Or you can defeat an alt. Well... oh damn, my tech-savvy skill is not up to snuff. Okay, well... huh. Yeah, who knows, maybe I will have to like come back later and... so, I want to concentrate on suave, but most likely tech-savvy. So, yeah, we only have one option here. We're gonna get our ass handed to her by Mio. Or, we're gonna get our ass handed to us by Mio.
Totally wrecked. That was literally the worst match I've ever seen. Well, take a shot. And I hope you're wearing underwear, because those pants now belong to me. Alright, time for round two. You'd better up your game, or it's going to get really chilly in here. And this floor is sticky.
I don't want to know why.
Fight!
Cheat. Play to win. Oh my god. Man, it's making me wonder, okay, how in the world would I do this? Well, actually... no. What if I would have taken the date, like, another time? Well... like I said, we're playing this casually, so... okay, Heart of the Cards, guide me!
Boom! Down in flames! That's what you get for facing the goat!
Heart of the Cards sucks!
That's a shot for you, and I'll take that shirt. One more, and I get a peek at your underwear. How scandalous.
Okay.
Ready? Fight!
Button mash, who knows, it might work. Resort to cheating. Lose, you can't compete. You're out of your league in more ways than one. Damn, so I'm gonna actually lose this.
Yes! And the winner is Mio! The crowd goes wild! Esports endorsements come flooding in! Alright, that's one more shot for you, and one shot for me. Let me see the goods.
You begrudgingly remove your clothes. You're suddenly aware of how not clean the arcade is.
Hey, look at you! You look good naked. You should consider being that more often. GG, by the way.
Well, she's blushing.
Looks like this bottle is almost finished. I'll take one for the team and give it a good home. Uh-oh. That was gross, but not nearly as gross as it should have been.
What the? You moo cow, you didn't even share. Okay, well. I definitely do not want to call her a moo cow. But let's see what happens. Don't worry, the stuff on the bottom always tastes better than on the top. Did you just shotgun 3 fingers of tequila? I think I'm in love.
Oh, well, you might want to keep that love in the shrink wrap for now, just in case that tequila returns for revenge.
Oh, hello.
Well, I don't know about you, but I'm feeling a little tipsy. Something on your mind? You look like you've got a few questions burning.
Okay, let me see. Can I ask you something kind of ridiculous? Can I ask you a sensitive question? So can I ask you something maybe a little inappropriate?
Yes, but only because you seem to be an expert on the subject.
What's the square root of 4,761? Oh my god, if you could be any item in Smash Bros, what would you be? If you could get sucked into any video game, which would it be? Huh.
Haha, you said get sucked. But seriously, the only answer is Super Mario Bros. 2, baby!
Oh, I see. Well.
Anything else you'd like to know?
This concludes the question and answer portion of our date. Hold on, let's see. Since I seem to be doing okay, let's not mess this up so far.
That's a bold move, Cotton. Let's see how it goes.
What is your deepest, darkest secret? Oh, hello. Do you kiss on the first date? Well, I don't know. I don't know which ones to ask! Well, I saved, so... Let's just get this out of the way. Let's see. Mio, do you have some very, very weird desires or whatever? Your undisclosed desires?
Ouch. No, not really. I just don't think it's a big deal. If people are nicer or more generous when you dress a certain way, I don't really see the harm in that.
Okay, good to know. Okay, let's see. Do you kiss on the first date, or what is your deepest, darkest secret? I feel like we're kind of getting to the... You know, like, let's not beat around the bush. I want to know your deepest, darkest secret so I can save you. Let's see. Well, that's probably another bad answer, so let's get that one out of the way.
Hey, I'm drunk, but not that drunk. I've got stuff I hide from people. I might tell you about it someday if I trust you. End of story.
Okay, sounds fair enough.
Let's see how it goes. Shoot. Blech. That's a gross question. Not because I don't, but because people who get hung up on that stuff weird me out. I'll kiss you if I think it'll be nice, no matter when it happens.
Well, surprisingly, that didn't take too much away, but...
Let's see how... Hey, I'm drunk. You're a curious sort, hey?
Okay, so I guess that one's just... That answer is just kind of neutral, so... Hold on, let's... Okay, yeah, so... Makes me wonder, like, I guess the idea would be we need to get the affection meter up all the way on our dates, so... See, ask you a sensitive question.
I don't know. Can you?
Okay, no. Can you prove to me you're a real... Oh my... This sounds... Well, I don't know if... This almost sounds like you're kind of trying to... be a bit of a douchebag to her. Like, are you a real gamer girl? I don't believe you. Like, you know. Obviously, I mean, there are guys out there who are like that to girls who game. But then at the same time, there are, like, fake gamer girls out there that are just like, oh, look at me, I'm with the controller, and whatever, so. Let's see. Oh my... Actually, all of these seem to be kind of douchebag answers. This one seems to be like the less douchebag answer out of all of them. Like, seriously, this one's here, like, is this all an act? I don't buy people. Like, oh, come on. Let's see, well, this is probably the lesser of two evils here. Or three evils, really.
Are you kidding me? I got boobs, I love games, I fit right in. Next question, queen.
Okay, yeah, so I would have to get my tech savvy stat up a bit.
So, is the interrogation over? Do I get my phone call now?
I just want my phone call. Let's see, this concludes the question and answer portion of our date.
Yes! Beat my PB on the speedrun. Let's keep it moving. So, what about you? Any deep, dark secrets I should know about? Anything you want to get off your chest?
I love motion controls. There, I said it. Automatic. I mean, I don't have anything against motion controls. I just have something against motion controls that aren't, like... You know, they don't work all that great, so... Like, take a lot of the complaints that people had about Zelda Skyward Sword. Let's see, I am on Secret Mission of Destiny, or... Yeah, she kind of didn't really go for that whole shtick the last time we said it, so...
You're figuratively...
Oh, hello. What? Why does she look disappointed? Mio turns away from you for a moment, retrieving the empty bottle she polished off only a few minutes ago. She looks down into the bottle and then playfully shakes it up and down, looking disappointed. As she puts the bottle down and leans against the arcade cabinet, twirling a finger in her hair, you can't help but notice small details you hadn't before. Her eyes are a vibrant burgundy, like Merlot beneath the sun. The bell around her neck has a small playful chime whenever she tosses her hair. Her lips have a soft pink hue, like watermelon candy. Her hands, her legs, her waist, everything about her seems relaxed and fun and carefree. She catches you staring and blushes. The way she unabashedly bites her lips stirs something in you. Or perhaps it's the drinks. No, it's probably stirring something.
Hey, seeing as we've gotten to know each other so well, I've got kind of a weird favor to ask.
How weird we talking?
Is this an okay segue? Are you worried that this is the part of the story where I turn out to be crazy and do terrible things to you?
I don't know, is this gonna be like one of those visual novels? Joke's on you. I'm into that shit. Hey, look at the time! I was just thinking about running away as fast as I can! So, if it looks like I'm getting smaller, it's because... I'm leaving! Okay, no. Let me just...
I somehow knew that was gonna be your answer. It's cause I'm a psychic type.
I'm a psycho. I mean, a psychic.
Okay, hear me out.
Okay. What is it gonna be?
As you know, I've worked in this silly place for quite a while.
Yes, I kind of figured that much.
All this, you know, beep boop zap zap stuff. Games, that's it.
With the beeping and the booping and the zapping and the stuffing and all, oh, you know what I'm talking about.
And for reasons I cannot fully explain, I wanted to do something here.
Oh, really? Like what?
With, like, another person.
What the? Finally, a use for my tearaway pants! Boy, but, wait, did she give you back your stuff? Not the most romantic setting for intimacy, but I'm following you. Are you asking what I think you're asking?
Yes. No, wait. No. Hold on. I'm not finished.
Okay, good, because I'm not finished either. What are the other options?
With, like, another person.
Here comes me!
sorry. That's not what I meant.
Okay, no. Well, she was almost going with it, though.
With, like, another...
What?
No, I mean, not that. But, like, thank you. That also sounds really nice.
Hmm. Okay, well then.
I was hoping that... Okay, this might sound either really dumb or really wackadoo, but I wanted someone to help me take some pictures.
Okay, sure.
You know, like, saucy pictures.
Okay, well, I'm still following.
You know what I mean? Wink, wink.
I would rather not. Yeah, that's crazy and dumb, and I love it. Why in the world would you want risque pictures of you in an arcade? Let's see, obviously that's to turn her down, this one to make her feel bad about herself, and... God, yeah, I'm using so many of these.
Yay! I've never been so excited to be called crazy and dumb.
Well, I may be stupid, but I'm not dumb. Mio takes you by the hand over to one of the arcade cabinets. She puts her hands in your pockets and takes out your phone. Shuffle dance.
Okay, hold on a sec.
Oh boy. Yeah, this is what I saw in those videos, more or less. Mio slowly pulls her shirt off and seductively takes off her shorts. Her underwear reminds you of peppermint candy. Mio is giggling and her cheeks are burning hot. She sticks her tongue out at you.
Okay, perfect. Go ahead.
Oh, and she's doing this in front of the crush machine! Okay, well... The music isn't helping me any, and that giggle she did. It's like, yeah, it's kind of unironic that she's doing this in front of the crush machine. You snap a few pictures of Mio as she poses in front of the arcade cabinet. She laughs and blows kisses and wiggles suggestively at you. It gets a little difficult holding the camera steady. I don't blame you! Mio pulls you in closer, hello, brushes you against you as she positions... This is where my tongue stops working because I'm getting flustered. Mio pulls you in closer, brushes against you as she positions you, bites her lower lip. Suddenly she jumps up in surprise.
Oh, I almost forgot! I need to play this game for sure. It's actually super important to get a few shots of a live game.
Oh yeah, definitely. See, this is the kind of thing that would get you people, or would get people being like, oh, you're just a poser, you're not a real gamer girl, and whatever.
Sorry. I'm sure I sound really ridiculous, but I appreciate your help.
What would happen if Mio meets Mio in Crush Crush?
Now get me those photos of Spider-Person.
Oh, get me those pictures of Spider-Man! Mio turns back to the arcade cabinet and drops a few tokens in the slot. She strategically points her butt at you and laughs.
Okay. Ready.
Oh, God. I don't think we should do that. And it's like, okay, we're just gonna yeet out of here. Or, let's see. So, yeah. This is what you probably shouldn't do. Especially if we remember Blanche in Crush Crush when she gave us that whole talk about consent. So, yeah. There we go. You and Mio laugh, joke, and flirt for the rest of the night. After her, you watch her get dressed, and the two of you look at the pictures you took.
Oh god, don't look at that one. It makes my junk look massive.
Ass. Okay, no.
Get it? Massive? That's so funny.
Yes, I got it. The two of you snuggle for a while in an enormous and slightly grotty beanbag chair. Do you know where that's been? Okay, no. Mio leans her head against you and seems to fall asleep for a moment. Well, I would say that's a pretty successful first date. She begins to slip and wakes up with a jolt.
Oh, wow. Okay, I'm pretty schnackered now. I'd better go home and get started on the hangover part. I had fun, though, tonight. You're neat. Let's hang out and secretly imagine each other naked again.
Okay, well, I mean, I wasn't doing that, but, well. She kisses you once, a strange combination of watermelon lip gloss and tequila kind of kiss. I brought the tequila, boys! Okay, no, I'm not Joseph Joestar. A short while later, Mio is getting into a rideshare, waving goodbye and blowing you kisses. After you've sobered up, you take your own car home. Well, hello, gorgeous. So let's see here. Mio's affection, level 3, date rank C. No secrets found. Current mood, lovey-dovey. And yeah, so I am going to need to... Yeah, there's obviously going to need to be a lot of things to figure out here. Ranging from figuring out which of the skills I need to level up properly. But, like, I don't know how we'd be able to get to the level 10 tech savvy, like, by the end of day 2. I don't know. And then, well, the suave as well. And then there's also the fact that I don't know if I got this too soon or not. Like, maybe I should have waited. Because, like, who knows, maybe I shouldn't have gotten this on day 2, and I probably should have tried going for, like, day 3. Not that it probably would have been any much better, but you never know. Okay, we're gonna go home. Right, so... Let's see here... Okay, so we can finally do the tech-savvy job. So let's see. The night air is strangely quiet. In the distance you hear the waves and nothing more. Dawn of the third day. You awake refreshed and ready to face the day. Alright, let's see here. Because yeah, you see what I mean? Okay, and yep, see, there we go, now we have $70. What, a suave lawyer? So that way we can be like Camille Vasquez. Let's see, poker pro, be a model, and be too sexy for my shirt. Gosh, I don't know. You know what, let's work on the suave stat, just because. I don't know. I mean, Mystic himself said it, some of these stats might be good for other girls. Like, even though Mio's main stat here is tech savvy, the suave one might have come in good handy. And then the morning comes. Okay, what do we got here? Greetings, time for another hinoscope. As you unfold more of the, let's say, story, there will be more and more demands on your time. Sometimes there will be people who want to do something at the same time, so you need... So you need to be careful what you book and when. If you're finding things a bit tight, remember that not all the people you can date are important to your quest. Some are for fun and giving yourself a challenge. And just so you know, it's possible to date everyone and
get perfect scores in everything, and still buy all of my hints, despite how unreasonably expensive they may become. If you wind up double booking, your best bet is to stand up the person you think would take it the best. Learning everyone's personality will go a long way to succeeding. Some people are just more willing to forgive than others. That's it for today. Good luck out there. Alright, let's see here. Bonnabelle and Elle.
Hey sugar, it's Bonnabelle Valentine, your friendly neighborhood cookie maker. I hope you won't think a country girl too forward, but I had your cell phone number burning a hole in my apron pocket, and I just had to do something about it. Would you be interested in a little get-together social? Maybe some coffee and laughs at the Queen Bean tomorrow night?
See, I never got a more enticing proposal, Miss Valentine. I'd love to. Oh shoot, I can't make tomorrow night work. I have a previous engagement. Let me see. Okay, we can obviously leave them. Well, okay, well, this goes against one other thing I say when it comes to, like, well, just friendships in general, but also romance. But yeah, be careful about leaving who you're talking to on red, especially for too long, because yeah, that's just going to make it seem like you don't really care too much.
Hello. I found this number in my phone, but I'm not sure who it is. Do you know?
Hey girl, what you up to? Is this Elle?
Oh, hello. Yes, this is Elle Reed. Sorry if I'm bothering you. I don't have your name in my phone. Unless your name is unknown number, which would be an interesting name indeed.
We met in the bakery. You were talking to the baker about cooking bacon. I'm a secret admirer. I admire you. Secretly. Nah, let's just be straight up. We don't want to weird her out too much, I don't know.
Oh, that's right. We exchanged phone numbers. I remember you very clearly. I think I recall that you wanted to talk to me about something. How can I help you?
I wanted to ask you out. Like, on a date. I was wondering if you wanted to go out sometime. Or go in. Together, I mean. What the? I hope this isn't the wrong one!
Oh, I don't know what to say. I've never been asked this before. I'm just so surprised someone would ask me out like this.
So, is that a yes? Great, what time can I pick you up? Well, don't be too forward now. Don't get too cocky, Star Fox. Well, I don't know, really. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. Oh, dear. Let's see. Did I mess that up?
Listen, I would love to have some company, but my family is very old-fashioned. I can't go out with anyone until they've met my family. This is just how things are done. So if you would like to, go out with me. Come up to our family estate tomorrow afternoon. Then you can meet my brother. Does that sound fair?
I'll try to make it, or fair enough, see you then. Well, I don't know.
Okay, and I will also see you. Take care.
Let's see, what do we have going on right now? A park event, the bakery, cafe. Well, if I'm just going to be trying to go through this, like, very casually and not to worry too much, like, right now. Like, this is just so I can get familiar with the game. So let's see. We're going to accept her generous offer here.
Ooh, now I'm excited for sure. Looking forward to it, sugar. I can't wait, in fact. I'm going to be icing the cake all day with a skip in my step. See you tomorrow.
Okay, then.
So according to Mystic, everyone is dateable in this game. So yeah, I guess if you wanted to, I suppose with that theory in mind, if you wanted to, you could date Eli, possibly even Dimitri, Lotus, and, well, does that mean that he's dateable too? I'm just saying. Well, let's see, let's go to the bakery first.
Hey, sugar.
Well, I do declare, it is the lovely Miss Valentine giving me a nice hello.
Why, you're just in time. I just took the cinnamon buns out of the oven, so they are as warm and sweet as a soft kiss.
Why, hello.
And don't you hit me with the word diet, or you'll crush my little heart.
Diet? I've never heard of that word in my life.
As always, let me know if anything catches your eye.
That was random. Okay, I guess we're gonna go back.
Just take a quick look. I can't see back there with my cell phone. You are my only hope, Lotus.
Help me, Obi-Wan Kenobi, you're my only hope.
Dimitri, it's just one gray hair. Don't be silly. And heads up, we got a customer. Hola, aloha, and hello. Welcome to the Queen Bean Coffee House. What can I get for you today?
Okay, we can either get the large coffee or just nothing right now. I'm gonna take Mystic up on his little hint about us needing $160 because, well, I'm still $90 short of that.
No problem. Let us know if you change your mind.
Okay, let's go to the park, see what this is all about. Well, this looks like a nice place. Stopping by the park, you take a second to appreciate the beautiful weather. The air is noticeably crisp, and there's not a cloud in the sky. What are you talking about? There's at least 3 clouds in the sky! 4! Maybe 5! Okay, no. A bee randomly flies past your field of vision, landing on a nearby rhododendron. A bee?! Let's see, leave it be? Smack a bee, or admire the bee. What happens if I admire the bee? Oh, money. Stepping in for a closer look, you discover a $20 bill under the rhododendron. How lucky! Well, there's the $90, now I need 70. You bid the bee farewell and continue on with the rest of your day. Let's see, now what do we have here? Eli?
Hey! It's Eli! Don't ask how I got your number. My ways are mysterious and fraught with fabulousness. Okay, listen up, sweet cheeks. Here's the plan. Eero goes for a jog basically every morning. That's also when she's in her best mood. Unless you're a joggy god, your best bet is to meet her at the park in the morning. She'll be on the tail end of her run, which will soften her up a bit. Tomorrow morning, park. Dress for sweaty success. Eero is likely to make you jog. You got all that?
I'll be there. I'll see if I can make it. Nope, let's see. I don't think there would be anything else.
Wonderbar! I'll be rooting for you. Be nice, and don't talk about gross stuff. Bye!
Let's see, real fast, though. Let's go to the mall! Is Eli gonna be there?
Do me a favor. Put this shirt on and look sexy. But not, like, too sexy.
Why? What happens if I look too sexy? You quickly pull the sweater on. It's a bit itchy. Why'd you make me put on this itchy thing? What's this thing made of?
Eyelashes!
Okay, no.
Afraid not. This is more of a meet the parents kind of sweater. I'm looking for a nice quickie in the library kind of vibe.
Okay, well.
Maybe I should wear glasses.
Well, I mean, it worked for the dude who was in the Cascada Every Time We Touch video.
Oh, thank you, BT Dubs. You're a peach. I've got to concentrate on this problem right now, though.
I wonder what problem that was. Well, let's go back to the bakery.
sugar. Nothing freshly baked today, I'm afraid.
But I was just here.
All the flour I got shipped yesterday turned out to be contaminated. National recall.
Ah, damn.
I think I might have a few sticks of beef jerky in the back if you're desperate, but for now, I'd encourage you to come back tomorrow. Take care, sugar.
Alright, take care, Bonneville. Alright, let's go to the park. So yeah, it seems like the park event is going to be available for us in the morning to meet up with Eero. So let's see. Well, we're here, back in the park again. Wandering around a bit aimlessly, you happen across a beautiful fountain near the park. Looking into the fountain's shallow waters, you see dozens of coins of various denominations sparkling at the bottom. Oh great, are you going to go taking the coins out like the guy in Genshin Impact and Mondstadt? And now you must make a decision. I feel like take all the coins would be like evil. We can be a cheapskate. Finding a quarter in your pocket, you toss it in the fountain. The quarter lands with a satisfying bloop. As you continue on your way, you swear you feel a little luckier. Alright, what do we have now? Oh shit, I didn't get back to Mio. Hey, how's it going? I just wanted to send you a quick message to say that I had a great time with you and... Brace for ramming speed. I mean, awkwardness. I just want to apologize for coming on a little strong. I get a bit forward when I've had a bit to drink. I just want to know that I did indeed have a great time, and I hope I didn't accidentally spoil my chances by getting all, you know, forward. Anyway, I hope we can go on another date soon. I promise to behave myself. Oh, behave! And the offer still remains open. Hey, okay, gotta go. Someone is puking somewhere in the arcade. This is Code Red. Take care. Talk soon. Well, you didn't ruin it. In fact, if anything, you're almost like, well, you're like my gamer girl dream girl, sort of. Whatever, what am I saying?
Hey, sugar. I just wanted to let you know that you were on my mind, and I'm looking forward to our little get-together. Hope your day is going fabulous. Drop in for cookies and hugs if it ain't.
Okay, well then. Let's see, and here's Cassie.
Alright, perfect McPeekaboo. I've decided to believe our little personal fender bender was an accident. But I sure ain't forgiving you over the phone. I want to meet, face to face. Meet me at the mall tomorrow afternoon. We'll settle this mano a mano.
I'm into it. So baby, come light me up. Okay, no. We'll see you then.
Hell nah.
There's no way I'm risking my life meeting you in Oh my, what the fuck? Okay, no. That's just pure douchebaggery right there.
Good, don't be late. And don't you dare stand me up. Bring cash.
Okay, is this gonna be the... Well, let's see if I'm gonna be screwed or not. Okay, kind of sort of a moment of truth time. Let's see... Well, no, let's get some of these out of the way first. The store is empty, like my soul. There's a sign on the counter that says, BRB! Just running to La Toilette!
That's Fancy Pants talk for the John! Back soon! Don't shoplift! God is watching!
What about here?
Now hey! How's it going? Did you drop in to play some severely outdated hardware with sticky control sticks? Or did you come to visit me?
Well, actually, I was kind of hoping to run into you.
Don't answer that. We both know the right answer, and I'm running with it.
Okay, I'll run with it too.
Hey, I've gotta go fetch a pizza from the kitchen for Cable 4, but maybe we can hang out tonight? Or soon?
I don't know about tonight.
I'll check my calendar and text you. In the meantime, I'm blowing kisses at you awkwardly. Bye-bye.
Okay. Well, let's see here. We have an event at both the park and the cafe. Alright. Wheel of Morality. Turn, turn, turn. Tell us a lesson we should learn. Okay, apparently we're going to go to the cafe. When you arrive at the cafe, you smell the unmistakable and alluring scent of roasted coffee beans, even from the street. Okay, yeah, so it seems like, if I'm thinking about the day now, we're gonna have to meet Cassie in the afternoon, and then Bonnabelle in the evening, so... There are a number of tables set up outside, but it seems like the inside is a popular hangout as well. It may have something to do with the free sample sign written in chalk on a blackboard by the entrance. Lies! There's nothing here about free coffee or free samples! Okay, let's see. When you enter the coffee shop, you notice right away it's empty, and the two baristas appear to be bickering behind the counter. You know, I think this might be one of the very few things that I've seen from the Kickstarter. Yeah, I think this could possibly be like the first time I saw the clip of them introducing Lotus here. Let's see.
I am just saying, my dear sister, that maybe you would have less troubles if you weren't so prickly. Yes?
Yep, this is it. This is indeed from when they showed off the Kickstarter. Let's see, I might, depending on what might happen, I might cycle back and see if the park is any different.
Do you see many cactuses on dates? Do you know why? Because they are prickly. Prickles say, do not date me. I will poke you in the face.
I cannot stand you when you are full of nonsense. Can't you go off somewhere else when I can't listen to your advice?
Do not fret, mi hermana. Those are just the prickles talking. I am just trying to help the cactus get some water in this dry desert heat.
But the cactus doesn't need too much water. Oh well. Like the deserts miss the rain, you mean?
Cacti can go months without water, mi hermano. They do not need you scooting around, commenting on their prickles!
Yeah, she's right. That's why cacti have their roots so close to the ground, technically.
Judging by yours, I would say it's been longer than a few months.
Oh, Dimitri! I'm going to start the shouting if you do not... Oh, Dimitri, someone is here!
Hi!
Hola, aloha, and hello! Welcome to the Queen Bean Coffee House. Please, excuse our little argument. We did not hear you come in.
We were just practicing a skit for... our Christmas community play.
Okay. Is this like the company play called Put That Thing Back Where It Came From, or So Help Me?
Dimitri, do not lie to the customers. Especially badly. I am so sorry. He is an idiot by choice. So please do not pay attention to him. What can I get for you? I would be happy to make you anything on the house as an apology.
Okay, well, I'm just an idiot by accident, so... okay, let me see. So that's where I wanted to cycle back. Let's see. Oh, wow, thanks. I would love an espresso coffee thing. No problem at all. Surprise me with something sweet but strong, like you. Okay, no. Just a coffee, please. And I think it sounded like good advice. I could use a bit of de-prickling, too. let's see, this one makes it sound like you don't know what you're talking about. And this one makes it sound like, well, you pretty much know something. And this one just sounds like if you're trying to get on somebody's good side, I don't know whose. Let's see whose good side I'm gonna get on.
Aha! You see, Lotus, cactuses recognize their own.
Cacti! Hey, please! Do not encourage him! Every time someone says he is right, he will talk about it for weeks.
She's so grumpy.
One coffee coming up.
So, you seem like a seasoned traveler with wisdom to share with the world.
Really? I didn't think of myself that way.
My dear sister here, she is what you might call unlucky in love.
Dimitri!
Oh God, you're talking about her love life right in front of her face, in front of a stranger.
But I think she is lovely and kind and wonderful, so I am trying to solve this puzzle.
Do not talk to customers about my love life!
See? Okay, well, I got on his good side.
I just think you could use an outside opinion, mi hermana. And I am getting a good vibe from our friendly customer here.
Okay, now I have to see for sure what'll happen if I would choose one of the other ones. Well, there's really only one other one I'd want to choose.
May I pick your brain? Do you mind?
Let's see, if you don't mind, I would like to drink my coffee in peace. Yeah, go for it. I love to chat.
Bless you, my friend. Lotus?
Let's see.
Oh, for goodness sakes. Whatever. Just please do not embarrass me on purpose. I hate it when you do that. Here is your drink, by the way. I hope you love it.
My dear sister has been on only a handful of dates the last 6 months, and none of them have gone past the first installment. She claims it is because there is no chemistry. But as you can plainly see, she is made of fire and lilacs. For there to be no chemistry would be scientifically impossible.
Dimitri, dating is not some silly app to get a high score. There are just no men or women that are my type.
Maybe. And maybe I will be magically transformed into a pig, go on a crazy adventure of love and discovery, and be rescued by true love's kiss.
Well, that can be arranged.
Anything is possible, but we should limit our discussion to the probable. What do you think, friend? Is Lotus the victim of the dreaded typeria?
What?
Dimitri? You? Are so gross and weird.
Okay, this one is going to be kind of fun. That depends. Are you turning down second dates or not getting invited? Normally, I would say your standards might be too high, but I really don't think that's the case. This is going to sound weird, but are you dating because you want to or because you think you should be? Let's see, this one, I don't quite know. This one, I don't know if this is exactly like shifting the blame onto her. And this one, it's a little more profound. Like basically asking yourself, who are you? And what do you want out of life?
That is a very interesting question. I don't really know the answer.
I would be shocked if you could have answered that to me, like, right away. But yeah, because that's kind of something that you have to really think about for yourself. Especially if you think, like, even if you are, like, dating, like, whether it be for the long term or the short term, you really have to figure out, like, what is it that you want out of this relationship? What kind of person are you looking for? And is it something that you really want, or are you just doing it because you feel like you have to?
You see, my friend, our mama, she wants the grandbabies, yes? So many of them.
Oh, I see. So then there's a chance that it might just be, like, pressure from the mom, then.
Dimitri!
Well,
it is just an observation. I do not care if you choose to date or not, mi hermana. I care that you seem to be having troubles and are in distress about it.
Well, I still think you are weird and a bad influence.
Well then.
Aha! then I am still right where I want to be.
Okay, well then. I guess you're pretty satisfied.
But go on, my friend. We interrupted you.
Oh my god. Real talk, are you a bitch? God damn it. If you're truly looking for love, then it's probably something you're putting out there that you don't realize. I think it's just a dry spell. Types and leagues are just lazy ways of thinking. Okay, let me just... Okay. We're not gonna ask her if she's a bitch. So then, let's think about these other two options. If you're truly looking for love, it's probably something you're putting out there that you don't realize. So the way you project yourself to other people, that's obviously how they're going to see you and how they're going to approach you and all that stuff. So obviously, if you project yourself in a bit of a negative light, then they may not want to continue talking with you and whatnot. So if you're unwittingly putting out some negative vibes and you're not realizing it, then that could be a problem. If that's what he's trying to say here. I think it's a dry spell. Types and leagues are just lazy ways of thinking. And this is kind of something that I still struggle a bit with myself, just when it comes to, like, how I just said, kind of half-jokingly said, like, Mio's like my type or whatever. In actuality, you might say that Mio, or at least the idea of her, appeals to me. So, you have that. Like, your ideal of a person is your type and what you look for. And league, like, if you say, like, oh, that girl's, like, way out of my league. She's so beautiful and charming and whatever. Like, well, I mean, there are some people out there that have kind of, like, broken those boundaries and gone after partners that are out of their league and whatnot, and they've made it work. I can't really name names, but I've at least heard stories, especially like from some friends of mine, about how they've kind of made it work. And the whole idea that if you're categorizing yourself between like types and leagues, well then you're almost not going to get anywhere. In a sense, I mean, I'm not saying, like, if this is how you think, well then, I mean, okay. But, like, if you want to kind of break out of that a little bit, like, you have to kind of stop thinking and categorizing yourself, like, oh, this girl's in this league, this girl's in the other league, and yada yada yada, I'll never have a chance. Like, no. You gotta figure that everyone has a fair shot at everything, so... Well, I'm done talking, so let's see. I'm gonna go with this one.
Of course you are right. I have dated so many, and I have never come across these types and leagues of which you speak.
Well, so far it seems like I'm winning over Dimitri.
That is only because Nathan decided to give you so many gifts, and rob you of a decent brain.
You wound me, dear sister. Your words are daggers in my beautiful heart. I think we need to run an experiment. We need to see the problem in action.
Wait, are we gonna have, like... Are you gonna have me be on, like, a mock date with Lotus?
Dimitri, if you are asking this kind of person to take me on a date, I will slap the tan right off your face!
Okay, okay. Orderly.
No. In science, you must remove biases to discover the tantalizing truths underneath.
Scientific method.
The next customer that comes in, you must flirt with them.
Oh, hello.
Aye! Dimitri, I am not going to be your conejillo de indias. And I am certainly not going to bother a customer for the sake of your amusement.
It is not to bother anyone, Lotus. Trust me. Almost all customers are delighted when the pretty barista flirts with them.
Let's see, I can confirm that 100%, or that might be true, but I don't think you need to worry. You're not asking them out, you're flirting.
I hate everything that is happening here, but somehow I will allow it.
Yeah, I have no idea if... Like, there's just a lot of I have a lot of questions there, like, how many different ways can this turn out?
Hooray! We have an experiment. Here is what we shall do. The next customer that comes in, you will try to flirt. And then, whenever you get stuck, our friend here will signal for what you should do.
Oh god, is this something like I could terribly mess this up for her and make her feel humiliated?
Sound good?
No, but I'm not fighting it.
You can't fight this feeling anymore?
That's the spirit.
That's the spirit?
Oh, there is someone coming. Everyone, to your places.
Assuming battle positions. A young man walks in and takes a very long time to read the menu. He looks at you shyly several times to ensure he isn't budging in line. Then he walks up to the counter.
Hello?
Oh wow, it's Nim.
Hola, aloha, and hello! Welcome to the Queen Bean Coffee House. I am Lotus, and I am very excited to make you drink.
That doesn't sound awkward at all.
I mean, to make your drink.
Oh, great. I'm excited to order it, I suppose.
Then we are both excited.
Yes, apparently so.
Yeah, I guess we are.
Okay, he's doing that pose again.
It is nice to have things in common.
Yes, it is indeed nice to have... It is indeed nice to have things in common. It is also nice to have it so that your tongue doesn't stop working.
Yeah, definitely. So do I tell you my order?
Oh yes, of course. Sorry, I was distracted by your hair.
Okay, well, that could be something.
My hair? Oh no, what's wrong with my hair? Is there something stuck in it?
Signal, it looks handsome on you. No, it is just very nice hair, caught my eye. Your hair looks great, like everything else. Fuck. These on paper, they all sound like very nice compliments and whatever. So, okay, we're not gonna screw up Lotus's love life here, so that's good. Let's see, this one, I'm not too sure about this one. Maybe a little bit overboard, but it can work, and... I don't know.
It is very handsome on you.
Let's see, did I mess up?
Oh! Wow! Thanks! I like your hair, too.
Actually, hold on, let me just see. Okay, can't we try this a little bit better?
No! Your hair looks fantastic! It matches your everything!
Well, you're not wrong. I mean, he has, like, bright golden yellowish hair, bright golden yellowish eyes, bright golden yellowish sweater.
Oh! Wow! Thank you! That's very kind of you.
Well, at least he liked the compliment.
I like your... everything, too. I wish I had an apron like that.
Well, it made the good thing chime.
So, what can I get for you?
I can't have anything with caffeine, just to be super clear. So I just like some hot water for mint tea.
Sounds good! I love mint tea too! It is so refreshing and it does wonders for your breath!
Okay, you see, now you're making good conversation with them. So, kind of an awkward way to break the ice, but... yeah, see, now that you're past that, you're making good conversation with them.
Sorry. Is there something wrong with my breath?
Okay, apparently not. Never mind. No, sorry. I'm getting tongue-tied. Oh, fuck! I would have to check! Wink, wink. There's nothing at all wrong with you. Okay, there's a few ways we can handle this, obviously. God, yeah, look at all my saves here. Eventually, I am going to have to start overriding some stuff. Okay, this is like, if we want to go full-on flirtatious with him, this is like the, if we want to appear kind of shy and a little bit, like, clumsy. This one, I guess it's kind of like a middle of the road. What happens if we go full-on flirtatious?
I'm not sure. I could check for you, maybe.
Wait, how would you... Oh! No, but, thank you for offering, I...
Okay. I kind of figured as much. That would be a bit too strong, so... Let's not. Okay, let's see. What if we try to appear a little bit like... Oops, I'm sorry, I'm just being silly.
No, no, sorry. I am getting a little tongue-tying.
Oh, you mean tongue-tied. No worries. I know how that is for sure.
Well, Nim seems okay with it.
And to be fair, I think I was starting to get tongue-tied the moment I came in. I get nervous when I have to order from people who are so...
Beautiful?
Well, talented. Yes, that.
Okay, it sounds like we made another right choice.
So, what can I get for you?
I already ordered.
Okirak. That smug face.
Oh, right. Of course. Can I have your name?
Yeah, it's Nim. There's an H on the end, but don't worry if you spell it wrong. It's a weird name.
Admittedly, yes, like the first time I saw Nim's name. Well, I didn't really say anything about it, but I was just here, like, thinking to myself, like, yeah, you don't see that too much. Like, the first time I saw his name, I was thinking of the game, like, Nim's Tales. Probably most famous for the Don't Eat the Mushroom story that Proton John did ages ago.
Beautiful name.
See, these two are getting along pretty nicely.
Oh! Well, thank you! I mean, I didn't pick it, but I don't meet many people who share it.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't think there's too many people who do choose their name at birth. Unless, of course, well, you're changing your name and whatever yourself.
What's your name?
It is Lotus. Though, maybe, if you go by what they call me around here, it's... Hey, lady, give me my coffee!
Hey, lady! Give me my coffee!
Well, I know how that is. My nickname must be Honking Noises, because I always drive the speed limit, and that seems to annoy people.
Oh, man. Probably a lot of road rage going on.
I know what you mean! It is like everyone is wanting to race, but they only get to the stoplights faster.
I know. Like, what's the rush? Seriously.
It's probably a metaphor for life, but darned if I'll be figuring it out.
Never thought of it that way. In the end, we're all going to the same place. Possibly. I don't know. I probably won't be able to figure it out either. Lotus stops and stares, smiling. Give him the drink! Ask him what he wants again! Okay, no. Make Dimitri get him the drink. Well, I'm pretty sure there's only one good way about it. Let's see... Yep, I'm definitely taking up a lot of these saves, but okay. So, get him the drink! Give him the chair! Okay, no, don't give him the chair.
Oh, sorry. I have gotten distracted again. I shall get you your drink.
It's like you're falling in love with him.
Thank you. I got distracted too.
And he's following in love. Yeah, he's following you, falling in love.
Here you are. That would be $2.95.
Oh my god. You charged me $10 for coffee. This is highway robbery.
Thank you. Here, credit card, please.
Great. Thanks for coming in today.
Do something! Do anything! Give him your number. Ask for his number. Okay, this one... Let's see... I'll just overwrite the save. Because, well, there was really only one good choice here, I would say. We can either ask for his number, or be a little bit flirty and give him your number. And this could definitely be setting you up for a disaster. So I guess in this case... Since you're kind of the one doing the flirting, and you kind of initiated the flirting to begin with, you do have the opportunity to just kind of, you know, like, if you want to continue talking, then feel free to hit me up later. That sort of thing. Versus asking him the number, I mean, that could work. But then, I mean, considering you are working as a barista, you know, you may not exactly have time for that, and who knows, you might even lose the number or anything can happen. But if you give him your number, it's like, well, he has it, and he can hit you up anytime.
So, before you go, just in case, I thought maybe I should give you my phone number?
To call me, maybe.
Oh, I don't need a number. I'm not one to complain. Even if the tea is awful, that wouldn't be your fault. I'm good.
Oh, almost like those how's my driving phone numbers?
Ah, yes, of course. Thank you. Thank you for coming to the Queen Bean.
Okay, let me see. Let me see if I do the opposite of my logic here.
Great. Thanks for coming in today.
Because, I don't know, Nim is kind of shy and a bit awkward in his own right, so... Let's see.
So, I wanted to ask you maybe for your phone number?
Yeah, this one I'm not too sure about myself, but let's just see where it goes.
Oh, how come? Do you need it for the receipt?
Oh, no! No, I don't. Sorry. I forgot that I do not need it at all! Silly me!
Okay, let's try this one more time. What's the other option gonna do?
Great! Thanks for coming in today.
Okay. Lotus, I hope you don't screw this up! Lotus... Oh my- Whoa! Lotus, you're going a bit too forward here! Well, that's one way to flirt with him! Lotus reaches across the counter and kisses Nim on both cheeks.
I mean, thank you for coming to the Queen Bean.
This is just how I repay all our customers. Oh, God.
Thank you! It was very nice chatting with you, Lotus.
Yes! Don't mention it!
Damn, girl! Oh my God, like, damn! I thought you were just gonna do something, like, clumsy or whatever, but, like, oh, hell no, I'm just gonna go straight in and kiss him on both cheeks. I wonder, what would the difference be? I don't know. I have no idea!
My pleasure. Have a great day.
You too! I panicked! I am so dumb!
Hey, well, at least you didn't just, like, suddenly kiss him on both cheeks like you could have.
No, Lotus. It's alright. I mean, you tripped right at the finish line, which means you did not win the race.
I don't know. Now I kind of want to see how both of the other endings would have gone for this.
But I promise you, that boy will not forget this day. It will fill him with sunshine for the whole year.
Yeah, I mean, and I thought they were getting along pretty nicely back there.
Why did I listen to you? It is impossible to listen to you and not be embarrassed eventually.
Such is the mystery of life. But now I must thank my friend here, whose advice and encouragement were among the finest I have ever seen. We have a long way to go, but if you ever want to kill a couple hours and help our dear Lotus again, please do not hesitate to drop by.
Okay, so it looks like this could be an ongoing thing here. And, well, he says so himself, if you want to kill a couple of hours, so... Like, I guess if you just want to... Yeah, to speed up time, you can come here and help out Lotus.
I am not doing that again. But yes, thank you for being so kind and patient. Please don't come back, but mostly for coffee or various snacks.
What about the snack right in front of me? I'll get my coat.
Now, if you two will excuse me, I have to do some cleaning. And I may curl up in a ball and die.
Don't die!
Oh, Lotus, you are such a kiddo.
Okay, it's night. Wait, oh shit. Oh shit, let me just see here.
Thank you! It was very nice chatting with you, Lotus.
Thank you for the surprise kiss.
Yes! Don't mention it!
Alright, see you later.
I panicked! I am so dumb!
No, Lotus. I mean, you tripped right at the finish line, which means you did not win the race.
See messages, nothing here. Alright, well... Nope, tell you what I'll do. I'll just leave it there for now. Because like I said, there's still a lot of things that I have to uncover here with this demo. So, yeah. I don't know how many days it goes on for, but well, we'll see. Anyway, well, that was definitely fun, though. I'm definitely enjoying this so far. Alright, well then, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys next time with whatever else I do. Stay golden, and later, folks.
Un paraíso lleno de amor. Bailando, bailando, amigos, adiós, adiós, el silencio loco. Bailando, bailando, amigos, adiós, adiós, el silencio loco.